Hello student, I am Vinay Kumar Lal, your English teacher. Today I will teach you a lesson, the Kitemaker, and this chapter it is written by Ruskin Bond. So let's see from the chapter. Here you see that there was only one tree in the street as Gali Ramnath. So here one street it is there, and this street it is basically famous by one name, Gali Ramnath. And there was one ancient banyan tree, it was there, and this banyan tree was grown in the crack of moss. And one day what had happened, that little Ali kite, it got caught in the branch of that tree. Okay, so you see that the boy, when he saw that my kite got caught in the branches, then this boy, he ran at the same time, and this boy, he ran barefooted. And then he observed that my kite got caught in the branches, so maybe it can be torn also. So you see, being a small boy, he ran towards that particular place. And when he was moving towards that side, he shouted to his grandfather also that my kite is gone. And after that, what we used to see, the grandfather who was sitting over there, the old man, he was just simply sitting in that way, that he was dreaming. And after that, at once he woke up and he asked to Ali, that Ali, basically what happened to your kite? That maybe the particular kite, it got caught in that particular branch. And he said that maybe I can give you another kite also. And after that, what happened? The old man, he started laughing, listening this statement also. And after that, he just started thinking that, and he said that you have to still learn that how the kite can be flown, because you are a small boy and you do not know how the kite can be flied. So because I am too old, so I cannot give you this practice that how this kite can be flown also. Basically, you are a small child, you do not know the how the kite can be holded also. So you see that here the grandfather, he is feeling that today I am too much old, I cannot give the practice to my grandson then how the kite can be flown. And after that, we used to see that the same old man, he remembered the time when man flew kites with great battles so far. And after that, he started thinking of his own time, and he started thinking that when I was younger, that time there was a big battle of kites flying. And he started thinking that we used to take the kites outside, and after that we used to fly the kite in that manner. From other side also, so many people, they used to come and they also fly the kite. And after that he remembered that kite flying was then the sports of kings also. And the old man remembered how the Nawab himself would come, and after that they also used to fly the kites. And that even not only the Nawab used to come, even he used to just bring with him his assistants also. And so many people, they used to assemble at one place, and after that they used to fly the kites also. And after that he used to see and think that Mahmud the kite maker had prime time, had been the life well known throughout the city. And this person, Mahmud, who is the kite maker, and now he is the grandfather as well as old man also, he was very popular in making the kite. And after that we used to see, that time he says that the kite was sold in 3 or 4 rupees. And after that he said that then once a time the Nawab of that particular place, he requested to the kite maker Mahmud that please make one kite for me. And after that you see that he remembered that how marvelous kite he made for Nawab, and he said that he had made a very special kind of kite, unlike any that had been seen in the district. And this kite, it was very different, that even the people couldn't see the kite in the district also. And if he says that it considered a series of small, very light paper discs trailing on a thin bamboo frame, and at the end of each disc he fixed a string of grass, forming a balance on both the sides. A fantastic face was painted on the surface, with 2 eyes made a small mirror. The kite looked like a crawling serpent. So you see that this particular kite, which it was made by Mahmoud, and he says that that this type of kite which I made, it was really marvelous. And he says that everyone had heard of the dragon kite and that Mahmoud had built. And the word went around, it possessed supernatural power. And this particular name, it was given to that kite, the supernatural power. And this kite also, it used to be heard by another name, and that was the dragon kite. And you see that a large crowd in assembled. And the first day, when the kite, it was going to be launched, okay, by the presence of the Nawab. And you see so many people, they came over there. And after that, we see that the wind came and the kite soared in the sky. That was a very memorable day. Here you see that this person, he is realizing that nowadays, the kite making as well as the kite flying is not a big thing. But that time when I was very small, that time this particular kite flying, it was one of the biggest thing. And so many people, they used to take a big interest also. And so many people, they used to come also. And he says that those were more leisurely, more spacious days. But the Nawab had died years ago, and his descendants were almost as poor as Mahmoud himself. And after that, he says that the time it passed, and after that we used to see Nawab died. And when Nawab died, after that we used to see that the particular kite flying, it became a very nominal game. It became a very small game. And even the descendants of Nawab, they also became very poor. And he says that after that the interest in the flying kites, it became very normal. So here he used to see and think that today the kite flying is not a popular game. And he says that there was this boy, his grandson. It was good that Mahmoud's son was close by and gladdened the old man's heart also. So by watching his grandson, he used to be very much happy that still the kite flying, it is there, and my grandson also used to fly the kite. But he says that in that spirit, the kite which used to be flying, in that way the kite is not to be flying. So he used to sit in one place, and from that particular place he used to listen the sound of his grandson also, that how his grandson used to fly the kite also. And after that, one day what he did, you see that he heard the Ali's voice in the distance, but he did not realize he was calling him. The voice came, seemed to come from very far, and one day Ali started calling him. And Ali was at the courtyard door asking that whether my mother has been returned from the bazaar or not. And when Mahmoud didn't answer, what happened? The boy came forward repeating his question. The boy was coming and asking the question again and again. And we used to see there was no sound. Mahmoud was silent. It means was Mahmoud was no more. We used to see, and Ali put his small brown hand on the old man's shoulder, and he met with no response. And after that, no response came from Mahmoud's side. The boy heard a faint sound like the rubbing of marble in his pocket. And after that, suddenly afraid, Ali turned and moved to the door. He then ran down on the street shouting to his mother. The butterfly also, which used to come and sit sometime on the beard also, even that butterfly also, it went away. And a sudden gust of wind caught the toe on fire and lifted it into the air. And after that, we used to see the same process. It started as the kite used to be flown at this time in a very normal way, in the same way nowadays also the kite is being flown. So children, this is the chapter. So again, you read the chapter when you open the book, so and try to understand it. Thank you.